Turf war in the Tamil Nadu Congress has exploded. Former Shipping Minister G K Vasan has issued a veiled threat to quit Congress, hinting at a possible revival of Tamil Maanila Congress. With the exit of Vasan's loyalist Ganadeshikan as Tamil Nadu Congress Committee Chief, the former Union Minister is fuming. He expressed his dissatisfaction against the All India Congress leadership, hinting towards a possible split. Vasan at a press conference added that he will announce his final decision on November 3rd.
Munnani thalaivargaludaiya maraindha munnani thalaivargaludaiya vadigaattudhalin perilum avargaludaiya aasiyin adippadaiyilum mattume iyakkathai tamilagathile balamana iyakkamaga uruvaakka mudiyum endradhaan anaivarudaiya karuthum. Enave வருகின்ற காலங்களிலே மக்கள் பிரச்சனைகளுக்கு தீர்வு காணும் வகையிலே வளமான தமிழகம் வலிமையான பாரதம் அமைக்க பாடுபடுவோம். நவம்பர் 3ஆம் தேதி பத்திரிகை நண்பர்களை சந்தித்து அடுத்த கட்ட நடவடிக்கை பற்றி நான் அறிவிக்க இருக்கிறேன்.
Well, I have just no idea as to what exactly Mr. Vasan or anybody else may have said. Mr. Vasan was a valued senior colleague in the government. If at all you want to ask any questions with regard to intra-party affairs, as I earlier said, the person to direct them to is the General Secretary in charge of Tamil Nadu.
As the protests were adjusted to the victims of the 1984 riot intensifies on the 30th anniversary, BJP's biggest ally, Shuddha Sirumani Akali Dal, has demanded a probe into the 1984 riots. Punjab Chief Minister Prakash Singh Badal, who is in the capital, said a special investigation into the riots, either by a special investigation team or the Supreme Court, must be carried out. The Punjab Chief Minister, accompanied by Deputy CM Sukhbir Singh Badal and BJP's Satish Upadhyay, was in the capital for the construction of a memorial in honour of the riot victims in the premises of Rakab Ganj Gurudwara. Protests were held in the national capital by the victims and their kin, demanding justice and bringing the perpetrators of the riots to book.
देखो उसको एसआईटी कहने, कुछ सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जज कहने, कुछ भी कहने, इसमें हर पहलू बारीकी से कि इस सारे कत्लाम के पीछे क्या साजिश थी, कौन जिम्मेवार थे, किन्होंने किया, इस सारा जिनको जिनके खिलाफ शिकायतें हैं वो उनको भी ठीक उनके एक्शन लेना, एफआईआर दर्ज करना, मतलब ये सारा कुछ एक देखना चाहिए.
बेकसूरों को कत्लेआम किया था, ये पूरी हजारों साल ये लोगों के को मालूम चलता रहेगा. इंसाफ तब होगा कि जो दोषी हैं वो सबको सजा मिले, और वो जब तक सजा नहीं मिलेगी श्रोमणी अकाली दल ये लड़ाई लड़ता रहेगा. और जो हमें मीडियम हम देखें, जो जो हम हर कोशिश करेंगे, हर मीडियम को यूज करेंगे जब तक ये इंसाफ नहीं मिलता.
आम आदमी पार्टी ऑल्सो हेल्ड अ प्रोटेस्ट मार्च अगेंस्ट 84 राइट अक्यूज्ड एंड डिमांडेड स्पीडी जस्टिस. Aam Aadmi Party has demanded that the centre should notify a special investigation team to probe the riots. The former Aam Aadmi Party government in Delhi had recommended setting up an SIT to probe the 1984 anti-Sikh riots for reinvestigating the FIRs while in the case which had been closed as untraced. The party also suggested that FIRs so far which have not been registered should be registered afresh. The fight for justice by victims of the 1984 riots hit the streets in protest early morning in Punjab. Protesters blocked train tracks leading to Delhi, stranding passengers and delaying many trains. The protest was led by Danga Pandit Welfare Association that started assembling close to the tracks in Ludhiana as early as 5 a.m. The blocking of tracks, according to some reports, hit the movement of about 20 trains. Farmer protests has turned violent in Mathura. These farmers were seeking compensation for their damaged crops. Protesting against non-payment of compensation for their land inundated due to construction of Gokul Barrage, hundreds of farmers today came out to protest. They blocked the highway, torched buses and clashed with the police, who resorted to lathi charge. At least 18 people, including 5 policemen, were injured in the violent clashes. Irate farmers halted traffic on Mathura Gokul Barrage Road and the police had to use force to dispel the angry crowd. Police beaten charged protesting farmers and fired shots in the air to control the farmers. At least 13 protesters were also injured and are undergoing treatment at district hospital. The residents of Damodarpura village had stayed away from celebrating Diwali this year in protest against the failure of the district administration to pay them compensation for their land submerged after construction of Gopal Barrage, despite several assurances in the past. Owing to faulty design of the barrage, around 1,000 acres of land of over 1,500 farmers got submerged in the water about 2 decades ago, said one of the protesters.
हम लोग शांति पूर्वक धरना देना चाहते थे क्योंकि हमारे लोगों हमें टेंट नहीं लगाने दिया गया हमारे लोगों को हमारी गाड़ियां वापस सुबह कर दी गई इसलिए मजबूरन हमको जाम लगाना पड़ा है 16 साल की समस्या है 16 साल से किसान भीख रूपी मुआवजा मांग रहे हैं लेकिन प्रशासन उनकी जमीन को हड़पे पड़ा है और उत्तर प्रदेश की अखिलेश सरकार से किसानों को कोई उम्मीद भी नहीं है कि वो लोग मुआवजा दे पाए
According to police, hundreds of farmers led by BJP activists blocked the Gokul Mathura road near the barrage. The trouble started when additional district magistrate Dhiren Pratap went on to the spot to pacify the protesters. The protesters pushed the city SP Manoj Sonkar during negotiations. In the ensuing clash, at least 5 policemen were also injured and have been hospitalized.
गोकुल बैराज के जब निर्माण हुआ था इसमें दामोदरपुरा औरंगाबाद के ग्रामीणों की काफ़ी कृषि योग्य भूमि उसमें चली गई थी बाढ़ क्षेत्र में डूब क्षेत्र में तो उनके मुआवजे की मांग को लेकर के आज ये लोग यहाँ पे एक प्रदर्शन कर रहे थे लेकिन प्रदर्शन के दौरान ही ये लोग यहाँ रोड पे ही बैठ गए हैं जिसकी वजह से रोड पे जाम लग गया है
The principal and the director of Bangalore school where a 6-year-old child was raped have been arrested. Section 188 has been slapped against the duo for disobeying lawful direction. Parents will soon meet school staff on Monday to decide the future course of action. As of now, future of 1,000 students is in jeopardy. Yesterday, a teacher was arrested in connection with the rape of a 6-year-old girl who was assaulted twice over 2 days at a private school in Bangalore on 28th and 29th October. School authorities have been in the dock for flouting safety guidelines. First violation by the school has been regarding the installation of CCTV cameras. The second big violation is the incomplete background check of the school staff and teachers. With the future of the students at stake, concerned parents are holding a meeting with the school staff on Monday to discuss the way forward. This is the fourth such incident from Bangalore where minor girls have been sexually assaulted and raped in well-known educational institutions. Kerala Chief Minister Uman Chandy has denied bribe for bar license allegation levelled on State Finance Minister K. M. Mani. The head of the Hotels and Bar Association, Biju Ramesh, has alleged that he paid Rs. 1 crore as bribe to renew licenses of 418 bars shut down last year for being substandard. Ramesh claimed that Mani had demanded a bribe of Rs. 5 crores. Chief Minister Chandy has said that these allegations against KM Mani are politically motivated and also denied meeting Biju Ramesh.
ഇത് അത് ഇപ്പം കാര്യം സാധനം ഇപ്പം എൻ്റെ കയ്യിലില്ല കൈ ഇതിരിക്കുന്ന സ്ഥലവും കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ ഇപ്പം ഞാൻ വേറെ ലോക്കൽ പോലീസ് അന്വേഷണം വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ എന്നെ ഇന്ന് പിടിച്ചെടുത്തുകൊണ്ട് പോകും അപ്പോൾ അതുകൊണ്ട് എനിക്കതിനുള്ള സാവകാശം വേണം ഞാനിതെല്ലാം തിരിച്ച് മീഡിയകളിൽ കൊണ്ടുവരും അത് അന്വേഷണ ഏജൻസിക്ക് കൊടുക്കുന്ന സമയത്ത് തന്നെ ഞാൻ ആ ഒരു ഏജൻസിക്ക് കൊടുക്കുന്ന സമയത്ത് ഞാൻ ഇതിൻ്റെ ബാക്കിയുള്ള എവിഡൻസുകളുമായി ഞാൻ